Good morning. Happy Monday. I am so excited to be here. Coming to you live from Costa Rica. It's Jocelyn. This is a interesting topic. I actually love, love, love talking about this topic. And this is our second Manifested Monday. So I want you to say hi in the comments if you are here watching with me for the first time, or even if you're not here for the first time, let me know, say hi. So I just got off a training call with my students in Transform, which is our 6-week, kind of like my signature program at the moment that I am absolutely loving. It's a 6-week, basically going from default to designed program that has, it's so cool. We're almost halfway through the 6 weeks and I love, love, love the wins these women are experiencing, these people are experiencing. So today we're talking about the laws of the universe and how we can work within them to live in flow and manifest our desires with ease. So pretty awesome, jam-packed day. And it inspired me to bring that a little bit of that into our talk today. So I want to talk to you guys about, like I said, a topic that I super duper love, and that is dreaming. Okay, dreaming. And maybe some of you that hear that are like, oh, that's, you know, what does that mean? Or that's, you know, it's whatever. It is what it is. But we've all been taught at one point or another to stop dreaming or to think logically. Has someone ever told you in your life, think logically? Like, how is it ever going to happen? How is that possibly going to work out? Okay. I don't live in that place. I don't live in logical. And I haven't for a very long time. And I used to think that something was wrong with me, right? I used to think that, you know what? How come nobody else thinks this way? Or why does this, you know, not make sense to the people that are around me? But then I realized that there's a whole world out there. There's that back up the idea that we are limitless. We're absolutely limitless spiritual beings having a 3D physical human experience here on this planet. Okay. We have the ability to create anything in our mind, anything at all, anything. Whatever we see in our 3D physical world, whatever we see in our outside reality right now was created by someone. And it first started in their mind. Okay. And probably being logical did not create these things. Let's talk about the airplane. I talk about this, I think, all the time. There is nothing logical about thinking we can create this giant metal bird and fly it at extreme heights and extreme speeds through the air. That's not logical. Right? That's not logical at all. But did those guys subscribe to what is logical and what isn't logical? Did they allow those outside circumstances, outside situations, outside, like even what's the word I'm looking for? Influences to affect them? Probably from time to time, they were like, yeah, this, you know, this is right. You're probably right. This probably isn't going to work out. But no, they did it. They stuck with it. Okay, Instagram, I think we froze here. I'm going to try again. So, of course, everything we see, I'm actually not going to try again. In our 3D physical world came from someone's imagination. It came from an idea, right? Someone persisted in it and created it into their physical reality. And so here's what most people do is they live through their five senses. What this means is we have five senses that are always on, right? Almost always activated. We've done this our entire lives. We've lived through these five senses. This is what we see in our physical world, what we smell, what we feel, what we taste, what we touch. These are all our five senses that most people live their lives through. So what I mean is that they make decisions with that is almost like a a filter, right? It's like they use their five senses to make decisions, or they set a goal from their current reality. I hope this makes sense to you guys. Some of you that might be brand new to this material or might be like, what are you talking about? So our current 3D reality is expired. What we see physically is a physical manifestation of our past thoughts, beliefs, and actions. Very basic concept to understand, right? What we did in the past brought us to where we are today, okay? What we did intentionally and what we did unintentionally, what we thought intentionally and what we thought unintentionally brought us to where we are today, right? If we want to know how our thinking is, we can look at our results. We can see our results now in our 3D physical world, okay? But if we want to create something new, so say we have this dream or we have this desire, which we're going to talk more about the actual how and logistics in a second. If we allow ourselves or give ourselves permission to create that goal or desire from our current 3D reality, we're going to create more of the same because it's almost like we have that governor on. Okay, so how do we get past that? How do we set a goal? How do we allow ourselves to dream after an entire lifetime of being told not to dream, be realistic, think logically, all of these things? We need to realize that we are limitless beings. We are limitless creatures, okay, with this incredible intellect, this ability to use our mind to create anything we desire, hold it on the screen of our mind, which is our fourth dimension, and with energy behind it, with intention behind it, spaced, constant spaced repetition behind it, we can bring it into our physical 3D world. We can manifest it. Okay, manifestation is a realization. Basically, it's expanding our awareness to a point that we can realize something that was already there. Already there. Okay, we don't, like, science and theology tells us that nothing can be created or destroyed. It's all about our awareness. This is something I'm working on with the Transform students, is like awareness is so key and so vital. Because if we don't have the awareness that, for example, okay, when we're talking about dreaming and say our dream is to live in Costa Rica, okay, but we don't have the awareness that it's even possible. Like, we don't even have this awareness that, you know, usually what happens is our logical mind is like, yeah, but how? Or how are you ever going to do that? Or like, what about this, this, and this? Like, that doesn't make sense. That's our logical mind stepping in. Okay. If we have this dream or desire that I desire to live in Costa Rica, if our logical mind is too loud, or if our subconscious mind doesn't believe it to be ever a possibility, we will never get there. We won't be able to close the gap and manifest and create it in our reality. It's not until we can see our desire as something that is totally obtainable to us, okay? And sometimes that takes practice. The law of relativity is a good law to use in this situation. The law of relativity states that nothing is big or small, it just is, until it has something else to compare it to. And so, interesting, right? When we think of something like, okay, I want to live in Costa Rica, we right away, our mind is probably seeing that as something that is not obtainable. So how can we make it look or feel like it is obtainable? That's what we want to be hanging out in. That's that energy we want to be spending our time in, right? So what most people allow their 3D circumstances. They're like, oh, well, I only make this much in my job. Like, how am I ever going to live in Costa Rica? Like, I work a job. How do I get time off? And like, what do I do without my job? Right? That's one thing. Like, and it's realistic, right? It's legit. But remember that being realistic isn't necessarily the space you want to hang out in. I definitely do not allow myself to spend any time there. And this doesn't resonate with everyone, right? Some people are like, well, that doesn't make any sense to me. So here's the thing, is that it doesn't need to make sense. Okay. You can allow yourself the ability to dream in a way that pushes you outside your comfort zone. Okay. I'm trying to say here that if you want to create something new in your life, give me anything. If you want to create something new, you need to change the way you think. Okay. You need to change the way you see yourself. You need to change the way you see your world. Okay. Because it's a habit. For most of us, it's a habit. Okay, to stay in our 3D world, to continue to identify through our 3D. It's a habit because most of us, it's the only thing we've known since we were born, right? Is that this is what is real. My 3D world is what is real. But it's actually not. Our 3D world is expired. It's old news, right? And what we can see and create in our fourth dimension, in our mind, is what is actually real. Because tomorrow starts tonight. I love that saying. Tomorrow starts tonight. Okay, so if you're new to this material, you might be like, what is going on? This doesn't make any sense. And that is okay. Okay, that is completely okay. Trust me that with some time, and maybe a little bit more time, this will start to make a little bit more sense, right? So I want to talk about another law called law of assumption. When we are identifying through our 3D world, and when we are living our life in accordance with it, we are living in, most of us, in the law, like in assumption, right? We are living in the assumption that things are as they are and are going to continue to be that way. Okay, what if we start to see things differently? What if we start to assume things differently instead of assuming that, you know, just like, for example, if we have a bad morning, this is a pretty easy example to understand. If we have a bad morning and we start to get into that energy of like, oh, it's such a bad day, having a horrible day, coffee spills on you. Oh man, I'm having a bad day. That is living in the assumption of you're having a bad day. That's something that's so, like, we've all done it from time to time. We still continue to do it, right? But it's developing the awareness of, hey, I'm having a bad day. I'm not actually having a bad day. I just had a bad moment, but I'm not allowing myself to become my bad moments anymore. That's the energy that we're working with here. So it does take practice, but it just takes a little seed of, wow, I have a new awareness because I'm now going to watch my thoughts. I'm going to choose my thoughts, and I'm going to allow myself the ability to dream. I'm going to allow myself the ability to think outside the box, to think outside what I've been thinking for years. And stretch a little bit, right? For somebody who's brand new to this material might be like, well, when I think about dreaming big, they think about very logical things. You know, they might think of, you know, a little bit better than they currently have, an upgrade to their car, the same model, but a little bit newer, something like that, right? They might think of a very gradual progression. Okay, I love that 3% raise per year. I'm looking forward to that. That is my growth and expansion. That is very linear, very logical. That's where most people hang out. So what I wanted to do today is just kind of plant a couple seeds of like, hey, it doesn't need to be logical. It doesn't need to be linear. You can actually, it's called quantum leap your life. You can actually close the gap in like extremely short periods of time. I've done it with my life more than once. Okay. And so for example, the other day I received a comment on a post about it not being fair because I had gone from government housing to living in Costa Rica. It actually made me laugh out loud to hear the comment because I love it. I love it. I love just having this ability to plant these seeds, these new seeds of awareness, and help people to challenge their perspectives. Okay. That's always been a goal of mine, or just like something I love to do for like years and years and years. I love to help people to break their own just challenge their own perspective. Like, what am I experiencing right now? Right. So anyway, this person had commented that, oh, it's not very fair. You were living in government housing and then you lived in Costa Rica. It's like, it's so funny because, you know, that person very logically is thinking probably that I was like hoarding money, saving money away for this trip to go and like live in another country and like all the things, right? Who knows what they were thinking, right? But I commented back and was like, yeah, actually, I was living in government housing and I chose to change my thinking. And through changing my thinking, I was able to quantum leap and move to come to Costa Rica with alone with two little kids. Right. And it's because I chose to change my situation is what I'm trying to say. You're not stuck where you are, no matter what. Okay. No matter what. And here's the thing is we all have this paradigm. We all have a program. We all have these, yeah, buts, or that doesn't work, or, you know, it's foreign. We all have these old ideas and these old beliefs. A paradigm is basically a collection of beliefs and habits that have complete control over us. It's honestly, they have complete control over us. It's the way that it's our lens. It's our governor. It's our everything. Okay. And so when we start to challenge the paradigm, when we, you know, maybe you're listening to this and like all these things, all these hows are coming up. This is so good because we start to challenge the paradigm. Paradigm will start to get louder, but through constant spaced repetition or through like a massive emotional impact, we can change the paradigm. And it's so awesome when we do. So I healed generations, I feel like, and generations to come by making the conscious decision to change my life, okay, to change my situation and not continue to subscribe to my situation. That's it, right? So when we're talking about dreaming, I hope that that's inspired you guys a little bit to broaden your horizons and think a little bit bigger. You don't need to think in linear concepts. You can think, if all things are possible, because they are, if all things are possible, what do I desire? What do I desire in my life? Think big. Doesn't matter how it's going to work out. The how is not up to you. The how has, you have nothing to do. You have nothing to do with figuring out the how. Okay. And that's where most people get stuck. Once we make a committed decision, we make a committed decision to this goal, this dream, everything starts to unfold exactly as it's meant to. Okay. We are spiritual beings living in a physical human body, having a 3D experience, right? A 3D human experience. So when we can detach, right? When we can detach from the outcome, the law of least resistance, we can begin to step into that flow, that in-spirit energy, that inspired energy. And we start to receive, hey, this is the first piece of the puzzle. Oh my gosh, it's leading me towards my goal of living in Costa Rica, whatever it is, right? It's the first piece. And so that moment when I crashed my mom's car, wrote it off, she was in Mexico, on the way to pick up my child, my little boy from forest school with my baby in the car, I had that intense emotional situation where I was like, I am not okay with this anymore. Right. And I took that committed decision in that moment, right? That committed decision to change my life. Said by September, I'm not having another winter in Canada. I'm not. And at that moment, it was just that coming winter. I was like, I'm getting out of the winter for that Canada winter, that coming winter. And I made September that deadline. Okay. And so what happened when I made that committed decision and had that emotional impact, that intense emotional impact, it had to be a car accident to like slap me in the face, right? Wake up. Everything changed. I changed. Right. And no, it doesn't need to be an intense emotional impact. It can be constant spaced repetition, basically brainwashing yourself into thinking differently, thinking different thoughts, thinking only thoughts that serve you. Most people think thoughts all day long that are old news. They're just reflecting. They're kind of just replaying old movies in their head, or they're thinking thoughts that don't serve them, how nothing's working out in their favor, how everything's a struggle, they never have enough money, how all the things. Why would we continue to think those thoughts? So I hope that if anything, you get that this little concept from this chat today is watch your thoughts, watch your thinking, because our thoughts and our feelings are creating our tomorrow. We're creating what's happening next. Okay, so once we have that desire, once we have that dream, we don't need to figure out the how. We commit ourselves to it and the next steps come. I didn't know how I was coming to Costa Rica, but I knew it was happening. And so everything worked out perfectly. My business grew as it needed to. Everything worked out perfectly to bring us to the place of getting on a plane. Cool, right? And then furthermore, everything continues to work out for me always because I have the belief that everything is always working out for me, right? Of course, I manifested my dream guy days after arriving because I deeply knew what I wanted, right? We need to know what we want when we're dreaming. We need to know what we want and to get super, super clear, detaching from the outcome and then allowing it to happen, allowing life to be in flow, allowing ourselves to live in spirit and take inspired action in spirit, right? So super interesting stuff, you guys. So anyway, if you haven't seen already, today is May 15th at the time of this recording. I am hosting a free 3-part masterclass called Dream on Thursday this week. So the 18th of May until the 20th. It's for 1 hour each day, 9 a.m. Central Standard Time, which is Costa Rica time. And the recordings will be available. This masterclass is basically going to break down these concepts even more in a more tangible way, a way that you can understand them even better. You might be feeling a little like I just kind of like threw everything at you right now. But I hope that maybe even just a little seed was planted as, you know, you have so much potential. You have so much goodness waiting for you to realize it, right? You do not need to limit yourself anymore. So on this masterclass, I'm going to teach you how to dream. I'm going to teach you how to remind you how to dream without limits, and how to put those dreams in motion. So on day one, it's a beautiful lesson that I go through, really breaking down these concepts. Day two, we talk a little bit more, and then we do tapping session to release and remove resistance and blocks. We talk about our paradigms. We talk about where we think we are and where we think we aren't. We talk about closing the gap and all of that good stuff. And then on day three, we do a visualization and we get even more clear on our desires and our dreams. And we begin to embody them. We begin to move them into the physical world. So it's a really powerful event. And like I said, it is free. The link will be in the comments. And please come join us. It's going to be really awesome. And yeah, share this. If you found value in this, tag some friends. Tag friends who need to know this. Maybe you've heard a few of these concepts around, but maybe you haven't, or maybe you feel called to spend more time with me. So either way, thank you so much for being here. I hope you have an amazing week, and we will see you on Dream on Thursday. See you later.